Hello students, we are back here to study probability. In the previous session, we were studying example 6, in which the data given is a tire manufacturing company kept a record of the distance covered before a tire needed to be replaced. The table shows the results of 1000 cases. Here is the table. The first row, distance in kilometer, second row, frequency, less than 4000, 20 is the frequency, 4000 to 9000, 210 is the frequency, 9001 to 14000, 325 is the frequency, more than 14000, 445 is the frequency. This is the data that is given to us. If you buy a tire of this company, what is the probability that it will need to be replaced before it has covered 4000 kilometers? This is the first question. It will last more than 9000 kilometers. Second, third question, it will need to be replaced after it has covered somewhere between 4000 kilometers and 14000 kilometers. Let us see how they are explaining the solution. Here is the solution. The total number of trials is equals to 1000. Yeah, it has been mentioned here that the table shows the results of 1000 cases. What is the record kept of distance covered before a tire needed to be replaced? So, the total number of trials is equals to 1000. The frequency of a tire that needs to be replaced before it covers 4000 kilometer is 20. Here you can see the table. The frequency of a tire that needs to be replaced before it covers 4000 kilometers. Yeah, first question is that. What is the first question? It will need, what is the probability that it will need to be replaced before it has covered 4000 kilometers? So, the frequency is how much? Before it covers 4000 kilometers is 20. So, probability of what tire to be replaced before it covers 4000 kilometers is equals to 20 upon 1000. Is equals to 0.02. You understand very well how it has come to 0.02. Let us see the next sub question. The frequency of a tire that will last more than 9000 kilometer is, what is the question? It will last more than 9000 kilometers. So, after 9000 kilometers means what? 325 plus 445 is equals to 770. After it will last more than 9000 kilometers. So, after that, what is the frequency? 325 plus 445 is 770. So, probability of what tire will last more than 9000 kilometers is 770 upon 1000 is equals to 0.77. The frequency of a tire that requires a replacement between 4000 kilometer and 14000 kilometer is, let us see the table. Between 4000 kilometer, what they have said, it will be needed to be replaced after it has covered somewhere between 4000 kilometers and 14000 kilometers, means from here till here. Sorry, not here, till here. By mistake, I had selected that. It is till here. Means what it is? 210 plus 325. Why? Because this is what? It starts from 4000. It is less than 4000. From 4000, between 4000 and 14000. So, 210 plus 325. It is 535. So, probability is how much? 535 upon 1000. it is 0.535. What is this probability? Tire requiring replacement between 4000 and 14000 kilometers. I hope you people are understanding this. The percentage, next example, the percentage of marks obtained by a student in the monthly unit tests are given below. What is the data of percentage of marks obtained by a student in the monthly unit tests are given below. In the table we can see how many unit tests are present, 5 unit tests are present. Percentage of marks obtained is 69, 71, 73, 68, 74. Based on this data, find the probability that the student gets more than 70% marks in a unit test. What they are saying, based on this data, find the probability that the student gets more than 70% marks in a unit test. Let us see the solution. The total number of unit tests held is 5. The number of unit tests in which the student obtained more than 70% marks is 3. Here, let us see the table once again. More than 70% marks, 71, 74, sorry, 73, 74. So, these are 3 tests where more than 70% marks are obtained. And total number of tests are 5. So, what happened? 3. Therefore, probability of scoring more than 70% marks is 3 upon 5. After doing the calculation, we are getting 0.6. I hope you people are understanding how we got 0.6. Else, I will show it here. 5 here and 3 this side. 3 is a smaller value, cannot divide by 5. So, 5 zeros are 0. 3 came down. We are giving a decimal point wise, smaller value. So, we can give a 0 here. 5, 6 is 30. And 3.5 is equals to 0.6. Here is a calculation I have shown you. I hope the concept is clear. And in the previous thing, it was upon 1000, you know it very well in decimals and fractions. You can convert it by removing the zeros, you can convert in the decimal point, or by removing the decimal point, you can give zeros in the denominator if the decimal point is in the numerator. I hope you know this concept very well. Let us go for example 8. What is example 8? An insurance company selected 2000 drivers at random, that is without any preference of one driver over another. What has happened? An insurance company selected 2000 drivers at random. What they have mentioned? That is without any preference of one driver over another. In a particular city, to find a relationship between age and accidents, the data are given in the following table. Age of drivers in years and accidents in 1 year. Drivers of age between 18 to 29, 0 number of accidents, 440 of them. Total drivers 2000. Total drivers 2000 randomly selected. Proceeding further, age of drivers in years 18 to 29, 440 of them 0 accidents, 160 of them 1 accident, 110 of them 2 accidents, 61 of them 3 accidents, and over 3 35 of them. Over 3, 35 of them. Next, age of drivers, 30 to 50. Zero accidents, 505. One accident, 125 of them. They met with 125. 125 of them met with a single accident. 60 of them met with two accidents in 1 year. 22 of them met with 3 accidents in 1 year, and 18 of them met with over 3 accidents in 1 year. Next age group, above 50, 360 of them 0 accidents, 45 of them 1 accident, 35 of them 2 accidents, 15 of them 3 accidents they have met with, and over 3 accidents 9 of them they have met. Okay. Question: find the probabilities of the following events for a driver chosen at random from the city: being 18 to 29 years of age and having exactly 3 accidents in 1 year. Okay, probability, the first is what? Being 18 to 29 years of age and having exactly 3 accidents in 1 year. Second, being 30 to 50, means between 30 to 50 years of age, and having one or more accidents in a year. See the second sub question. Being 30 to 50 years of age and having one or more accidents in a year. Third one, having no accidents in 1 year. Third one, having no accidents in 1 year. Okay. Let us see how they have solved it. Let us see the solution. Total number of drivers is equals to 2000. Number of drivers who are of age between 18 to 29 years old and have exactly 3 accidents in 1 year is 61. Let us see the table here. Age 18 to 29, number of accidents 3, 61. Total number of drivers 2000. So, probability of driver is 18 to 29 years old with exactly 3 accidents is equals to 61 upon 2000. 61 upon 2000. It is 0.0305. Now, how to do this calculation? We shall see it here. This is actually 61 divided by 2000. You can write this 61 divided by 2000 in this way: 61 upon 2 multiplied by 1000. First, do this division. Two thirties are sixty, simple thing. One is remaining. Agreed. This is smaller, remainder is smaller than the divisor. After giving a decimal point, I can take a zero here. 2 5s are 10. I got the remainder 0. Means what? 61 upon 2, I got the answer 30.5. But it is not 61 upon 2, it is 61 upon 2 into 1000. Means, in other words, In other words, it is 30.5 upon 1000. It is 30.5. What is 30.5? We have seen just now, 61 upon 2 up upon 1000. 61, here it got dropped. Okay. In the denominator, we are having 3 zeros. Sometime before I mentioned that using a knowledge of decimals and fractions, I am removing these 3 zeros. So, what will happen? The decimal point will get shifted 3 digits to the left hand side. The decimal point will get shifted to 3 digits to the left hand side. Okay, I understood. 1 digit, 2 digit, only 2 digits are present. Now, how to make about the third zero, that is the third digit? Simple thing, 305, decimal point should go one more digit on the left. I am giving 0, decimal point is present here, 0.0305. Here you can see the answer. I hope the concept is clear. How it came to 0.0305, I think the concept is clear. Proceeding further, it is approximately or equivalent to, it is approximately 0.31. I am rounding it up to 3 digits after the decimal point. So, after the second digit, it is 5. If it is 5 or greater than 5, I will increase the previous digit by 1. So, it is 0, it will become, I will add in that 1, it becomes 0.031. This is the probability of this event. Proceeding further, the next event, being 30 to 50 years of age and having one or more accidents in a year. Let us understand the table properly. Being 30 to 50 years of age and having one or more accidents, one or more accidents means one accident, two accidents, three accidents, or over 3 accidents, 125 plus 60 plus 22 plus 18. Here you can see 125 plus 60 plus 22 plus 18 is equals to 225, is equals to 225. So, probability is equals to 225 upon 2000. It is equals to 0.1225, which is equivalent to 0.113. Now, how this 0.1225 has come, you people can do the calculation and solve it, and you can see that. Proceeding further to the third sub question, the number of drivers having no accidents in 1 year. The number of drivers having no accidents in 1 year. That is, under the column 0, we have to add all of them. There is no age. They have said the number of drivers who have no accidents, that is 0 number of accidents. So, it is 440 plus 505 plus 360. 440 plus 505 plus 360, it is 1305. So, 1305, therefore, the probability of drivers with no accident, 1305 upon 2000. Now, we shall do one thing, we shall do this calculation here. Which one? 1305 upon 2000. We shall do this calculation here. Again, the same thing. 1305 upon 2000 means 2 into 1000. This division becomes easy for me. What is that? 1305 is been divided by 2. 2, 6 is 12, 0, next 0 brought down, 0, which is smaller than, that is why next digit brought down, 5. When this 0 is brought down, I am putting here a 0. Why I am putting here a 0? The reason is very simple, because this 0 means this remainder value is smaller than my divisor, so I cannot divide. So, 2 zeros are 0 actually it is, I have not done that step, or I will do one thing, I will do it in detail. Instead of taking 5, I have taken the next 0 here, 2 zeros are 0. Then what happened? As it is. Now, my next digit is coming down, that is 5. 2, 2s are 4, 1. Now, the remainder has gone down, means it is below my divisor. Now, I am giving a decimal point, I can give a 0 here. So, this becomes 2, 5 is a 10. 2, 5 is a 10. This becomes 2, 5 is a 10, 10 minus 10, 0. So, what is the value here? The value here is 602.5 upon 1000. 602.5 upon 1000. Okay. Proceeding further. Using my knowledge of fractions and decimals, if I want to remove these 3 zeros, I have to take my decimal point to the left hand by 3 digits, by 3 places. So, this will become 1 place, 2 place, 3 place. So, this will become 0.6025. I cannot write here, there is no space, that is why I am writing here. It becomes 0.6025. And here we can see 0.653. Oh, something has gone wrong here. I have, there is a mistake I have done. Right. Here is a mistake. Here was a mistake. Right, right it is. What the mistake is, it was 13 there and I wrote 12. And I thought it is 12 minus 12. So, it is 1 that is remaining here and this 0 is brought down, it is 0 from here. And here the mistake happened. Here the mistake happened. Yes. So, 2 6 is 12, 1 remaining 0 came down. 2 5 is 10. Okay. This is 0. And now what came down? 5 came down. 2, 2s are 4. 2, 2s are 4. 1 remaining. Smaller than my remainder. So, I am giving a decimal point here. And then I can give a 0 here. 2, 5s are 10. Yes, now I am getting 0 here. What I am getting here, it is 652.5. I had written the wrong thing, 652.5. And here it is becoming 0.6525. It is becoming, after rounding up to 3 digits after the decimal point, it becomes equivalent to 0.653, and which is the answer you can see here. In this way, the division can be done and we can get this answer. I hope the concept is clear. Now you will be able to do the division. I had done a mistake here. You people can learn from my mistake what exactly went wrong there. In my division, it was 13, and by mistake, without seeing it properly, I wrote 13 minus 12 as 0, it was 1. That's why my quotient or my answer went wrong. So I hope that this is okay with you. Therefore, the probability of what? Drivers with no accident is 1305 upon 2000 is equal to 0.653. Proceeding further, for the next example, consider the frequency distribution table 14.3, example 4, chapter 14. Not in this chapter it is. It is example 4, chapter 14, which gives the weight of 38 students of a class. What is that data? That data is of weight of 38 students of a class, and it is example 4, 14.3 table number. Let us go behind. We have to turn our pages back. Table 14.3. Okay. So, this is the 14th chapter that started, and where is this is 14.12 just now which went on. Where is the table 14.9 yet we are at? This is 14.5. Oh, somewhere we are. I hope, what is the table number or no? 14.4. Yeah, 14.3. Here we are. Let us study this table properly. What is this data? Weights in kgs and number of students. 31 to 35, 9 of them. 36 to 45 of them. In this way, 70 to 75, one student is present. Total number of students are 38. So, just now we have seen the table 14.3. Now, let us see what are the questions that are based on that particular table. Find the probability that the weight of a student in the class lies in the interval 46 to 50 kg. And the second question, give two events in this context, one having probability 0 and the other having probability 1. Please understand the questions carefully. Find the probability that the weight of the student of a student in the class lies in the interval 46 to 50 kg. 46 to 50 kg. Let us move back to the table to see that what exactly is in 46 to 50 kg. For 46 to 50 kg, you can see number of students 3. 46 to 50 kg, you can see number of students 3. Total number of students are 38. Let us move to the question. So, just now we have seen the table. Here it is. Total number of students is 38, and the number of students with weight in the interval 46 to 50 kg is 3. So, probability of weight of a student is in the interval 46 to 50 kg is equals to 3 upon 38 is equals to 0.079. Proceeding further, this calculation how to do? Just now I have shown you the division. On that basis, you people can do it. Let us go for the second sub question. Give two events in this context, one having probability 0 and the other having probability 1. For instance, what is the explanation? Please see. For instance, consider the event that a student weighs 30 kg. Since no student has this weight, the probability of occurrence of this event is 0. Similarly, the probability of a student weighing more than 30 kgs is 38 upon 38 is equals to 1. Let us go back to the table to verify both the things. What? To see the probability as 0 and as 1. Let us go to the table here. Here you can see the weights have started from 31 to 35, means below 30 no student is weighing the weight in cages below 30, it is above 30. And so the probability that weight of a student is less than 30 kgs is 0, no possibility. And for the probability as 1, the weight of the student greater than 30 kgs, all the number of students, whatever 38 we have seen, all of them, they are weighing above 30 kgs. In this way, we can understand that whatever solution is been given here, it is the same thing. Similarly, the probability of student weighing more than 30 kgs is, how many of them they are there? 38. Why? Because total number of students who have been weighed are 38. So, 38 upon 38 is equals to 1. I hope you people have understood this clearly. In this session, we shall conclude here, and in the next session, we shall continue further. Till that time, you people take care of yourselves and study regularly and properly. Thank you.